they'll make their way back in a glass coach. But either way, it'll look and feel like a fairy tale. In London, I'm Don Riddell.
Well, if you can't make it to London for the royal wedding, we've got the next best thing, creating your own royal party fit for a prince and princess. Stacey Nelson with Trash Lassies shows us how, and the good thing is we're high class, but we're not paying a high price.
That's right. That's right. Well, we're going to show you a little tweak on a British party with our British invasion theme. And, you know, you can still celebrate these royal nuptials without spending a fortune. Just go a little different direction.
I like it. I love the blue. I love the blue in Stacey's hair, too.
Blue blood. Yes.
Yeah, you are a blue blood, darling. I should bow to you.
Oh, please. No, you know, it's great that the colors of our pals across the pond are red, white, and blue. So when purchasing party supplies, choose items you can actually roll right into the 4th of July if you have any leftovers. And, you know, a great fast fix to an instant theme, office labels as stickers. You know what? This is great. They come in all sizes,
perfect,
all shapes. They're available at the Mega Marts and, you know, the big office stores. Go online, find the image or theme you want to use, print it out, stick it on. Bowls, glasses, vases. This is a great, inexpensive way to get Fido into the act. You stick it right on his doggy wear.
I love it. Great?
Not on your doggies, just on their clothing.
Just on their clothing.
Now, to achieve that kind of funky London retro fusion, you're going to blend styles you wouldn't typically place together, like kitsch decor with Fenton and Murano glass, lava lamps. I think
Kate Middleton has that lava lamp in her room. I do.
I bet it goes after Friday if that's
yeah,
true. Think 1960s, think Austin Powers, but stick with the reds and blues for this British invasion. And, you know, hit your yard sales, scout your garage, look for items you can kind of paint to make that eclectic theme. And, you know, it's just kind of a fun and funky twist on a royal wedding theme.
Well, Stacey, if people haven't seen you before, Trash Lassies, you're set designers.
Exactly.
Sets for TV shows, movies.
Yep, we're basically on-set stylists. We do rooms, parties, themes. We do also a lot of special events and fundraisers and things like that. So we're always trying to save a buck. And not only that, trying to repurpose for the environment. You know, save as much as you can, blend it into the next holiday. So we all have too much junk, so let's use it.
Yeah, let's pull it out and use that junk.
Well, you can't think British invasion without flower power. I love this kind of atypical way to use shoes and flowers together. You know, they're two of my favorite things.
I don't know about you.
You can go classic Brit with some plaid tennies or kick it up with some new heels.
I hear the Queen will be wearing these tomorrow morning.
But I don't think the Queen. You know, new clean shoes only, please. No dirty, smelly shoes on the table. But, you know, it's decor now, and then you have a new shoe fix for later. Now, for a twist on big food, you can do some bite-sized bundles of Prince William's favorite cottage pie in these mock cottage mini pies. Mm. Serve up a platter of the Queen's purse. They're stuffed with walnuts and rosemary, all the flavors of jolly old England. I love this Union Jack-inspired fruit pizza. It's a great dessert, and it's double duty because it's table decoration.
Well, what's in there under the strawberries and the blueberries?
It's actually a crust made out of sugar cookies, and then it's cream cheese with a little vanilla and sugar. And then you just arrange the fruit on top.
That sounds better than any English food I've ever had. I know.
Speaking of English food, you know, have a few things of authentic English imports on hand. Hayward's silver skin onions, maybe some cans of Commoner's spotted dick pudding.
Mm.
Have you ever tried that?
I can't say that I have, Stacey.
Spotted dick pudding, it's interesting. It's an acquired taste. It's not very good.
What does it taste like?
It's kind of slimy, and it's not real sweet.
Wow, that's a good sell.
Yeah. Well, if you're going to eat on the spotted dick, you're going to need some liquor.
So yes.
Pudding. Did I say pudding? If you're going to eat on the spotted dick pudding, you're going to need some liquor. British beer is readily available.
Have you been drinking already?
I wish. You know, Bass, Fuller's, they're all here. And recently, Meantime has hit the U.S. It's a great British ale, and I love it. It comes in this super cool champagne-style bottle. I'm a sucker for packaging. So, and we've created a few of our own. We have the Prince William Blue Blood Martini, Blue Curacao, gin, and vermouth. And we have Kate's Golden Grace, orange juice, sweet vermouth, and gin. And my favorite, my invitation didn't arrive, Bloody Bitter Brit. It's filled with vodka schnapps and a whole lot of bitters.
Bitter party of one, and it's just your size.
Absolutely. You know, get some fun, festive things going for your British party. You can present a real fun tweak on a British themed party. You know, just search your house, hit some yard sales. Oh, and if anyone is going to be in LA tomorrow night, please join us Trash Lassies at Rock and Royalty to Erase MS. It's royally themed this year, presented by Nancy Davis and Tommy Hilfiger. And our favorite Brits, Sharon and Ozzy, are hosting.
Oh!
She's flying all the way back in order to make our event late tomorrow night.
That's wonderful.
So it's going to be a great event, and it's an excellent cause.
Plus Joan Jett. You know,
absolutely. We have Joan Jett.
Wonderful tips for our own party that's fit for a prince or a princess.
Absolutely.
Stacey, thank you so much for coming
pleasure.
On today.
My pleasure.
Darling, I just love what you've done with the place. Cheers.
You.
More information, go to our website, sandiego6.com, and you can click on San Diego
can we
Living.
Toast the royal couple?
Thank you.
William.
Here we go.
Willie Cat?
Yes. I'll let you finish it.